When you are sharing your data inside of SmartSuite, you want to make sure that people are seeing it in the way that you want them to. You want to be able to cultivate that experience. Well, thanks to dashboards, we have a lot of control over how we look at and analyze the underlying data inside of our solutions. That is exactly what we're going to be covering in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. And one of our favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite, which we are going to be breaking down in this video. Now, before we get started, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. Automation is the key to no-code tools. It's going to wind up saving you tons of time on all those repetitive admin tasks that you do over and over again. So, if you don't already have the fundamentals mastered behind no-code automation, grab my free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. That is going to give you the ability to sign up, get instant access to that training so that you can start mastering no-code automation and saving tons of time. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here and start covering this outlined solution. Now at a high level, I've got four different applications here. I've got my clients, which stores just contact information. I've got my invoices here. This is where we're linking up to a client and also producing some line items. So we can add multiple different line items to an invoice if we sell more than one thing at a time, which most of us do. Now, we've also got our line items here. This is the other application here where we're showing the total, the quantity that was purchased and the price per unit. Pretty straightforward stuff here. And of course, we're also linking to a product. So that's our fourth application. On our products application here, we've got, you know, the name of the product, what it is, and of course the price of that product. So all of this is already built on the back end. We've done plenty of videos in the past showing you how to set up invoice schemas inside of your no-code database tools. So be sure to check those out if you have any questions. Now, what I want to really focus on here is all about that data in my invoices. I'm looking at my invoice totals here, and I want to know what is happening in terms of our financial standing as an organization. And another thing that I really need that I don't yet have on this particular view is going to be an additional field where we mark the status of this invoice. So let's go ahead and name out a status field type here. Notice that this is a project essential, but I don't have to necessarily use the defaults for the projects. Instead, I might have something like not yet sent. I might then send an email, so have it sent. I might have a paid invoice, and then we might have an unpaid or overdue or something along those lines. Now, I want to also point out that we can change here what will mark this invoice as complete. So basically saying, if one of these two statuses is hit, then it's no longer going to be an outstanding item. Well, that's not really what I want. I don't want it to be a completed thing if it's overdue. So I might, you know, do a couple things here. Reorganize the status here. Also change the colors just to provide a better indication as to what's going on. Overdue is a bad thing. Paid is a good thing. So, you know, we can do some color coding to kind of suggest what we need to be paying attention to and what is in the clear. So once we're happy and all set with that, let's go ahead and add the field. Now, I want to point out that we can also manage this status based on automation. So we might set up rules that say something like, well, this invoice was created on this day, so therefore we know that it was at least a default of not sent. We know it's been created, and when it was created, we have that date marked here, and we know that the first, you know, status should always be not yet sent. So we can actually set this up by drilling into our status and putting out a default saying, hey, when I create a new record, it's going to automatically have this particular status, and we're going to update that status over time. Okay. And then we could also build other automations that say, hey, when we mark down a date as being paid, that will automatically move it to be paid, for example. So just want to point out that given that we have these other dates, we could be driving this status field based on how this other stuff is filled out. But for our example here, let's just fill out some different pieces of information, presuming that, you know, these different invoices are in various stages. All right, so moving into the next phase here, we're going to go into the dashboards. And this is what we want to really focus on. And we're going to drill into this dashboard view type. Now, what I want to point out is the dashboard is simply a view type. It's not going to recreate all of your data for you. It's just going to enable you to visually see that data in ways that are perhaps easier for you to draw actionable insights from. So when we look at a spreadsheet, this grid view, it's not doing a whole lot for us. But by creating a dashboard, we can include a lot of different elements. SmartSuite calls these elements widgets. So let's do a quick exploration. We've got some metrics, so we can put out some numbers, right? Just calculating maybe certain totals within certain categories, etc. We're going to include an element of this. We also might want to put together a bit of a graph that shows where our different invoices are within the various stages and over time. We might also want to include some other types that don't really pertain to our example here, like including some Zoom embeds or a Google Meet embed. We also have a couple of design elements with Figma and InVision widget. We've got some Google options, so we can just embed a Google Sheet right on in here. Again, we're going to that Google Meet, Google Slides, and Google Docs. There's a lot of different options here, and obviously I'm just scratching the surface. A lot that you can do, embedding web pages directly, clocks, all kinds of stuff, countdowns. But what I want to really focus on are these top metrics here, the metrics and the charts. So let's drill into this. Now, we, in our scenario, are looking at our different invoices that we've sent out, and they're in various stages. So maybe we bring in like this progress metric to see exactly how many of our invoices that are in a certain stage there are in summation. So for example, in our invoices application, again, we have to choose what data we're looking at. We can drill in and say, well, let's see, we want to actually look at that invoice total and we want to sum it, but only under certain metrics, under certain filters. In our example, let's suppose that we want to look at those scenarios where we've actually closed or received money for the invoice. So I can apply a filter. Here I'm going to say, well, look, I only want to see where the status is, in our case, paid. When I'm happy with this, I have to make sure to say save changes. Otherwise, that filter can get lost pretty easily. So make sure that you notice that your filter is still here. If it accidentally removes, make sure that you're saving changes as you go. Now, the other piece I really need here is my goal. So let's say I have a goal of $100,000. Well, this widget is telling me that, look, you've collected almost $12,000 against your goal. So let's go ahead and save changes and take a look at the underlying data. Remember, the whole point of the dashboard is to allow us to see our data in ways that allows us to make actionable decisions without getting bogged down by the spreadsheet feel of things. So let's flip back over to that grid view and see if this just seems right. Here we've got two paid invoices. This one doesn't have any total on it, so this is kind of silly that we would mark it as paid. But here we've got 11,800, and that is what's showing up as paid. Now you'll notice that if we make changes here, if let's say we receive this invoice and our accounts receivable team comes in and says, this is paid. Well, at a glance here, we can see that our total received invoices now is closer to 56,800. And of course, if we flip back into our dashboard, that is what we're gonna see here. So it's gonna show us that amount. But again, for this particular metric, because we use the progress metric type, it's going to be graphing that against a goal. And so this is great. If for some reason, or in the case where we seem to overcome our goal, let's say for example, our goal is only 50,000, we are going to see that metric represented by an entirely filled out bar. And we're going to see the actual total right here as compared to the goal right here. So you can set up additional filters here. For example, you might want to build a dashboard for the current month. And so in that case, you might set up rules that say, well, for this particular metric, I only want to look at things that were closed out, invoices that were paid within a certain time frame, so that I'm able to see relevant data to either a month, a quarter, you get the idea. So there's a lot we can do with this progress metric. Now, the other one I really want to highlight here is going to be one of those charts. So if we scroll on down, we see the bar chart, the column chart, donut, pie, and line. These work relatively similarly. In our example, I'm going to go with the column chart here. And when we set this up, Just as before, of course, we have to map it to a specific solution and to a specific invoice. Now, before I go on and kind of detail out other parts of this, what I do want to point out is that because of the way that SmartSuite works, we don't have to necessarily be bringing information into this dashboard that lives in this solution. SmartSuite is so open that we have access to all of our different solutions inside of our workspace. So for us, we want to bring in data that relates to our invoicing solution, but you can very easily set up dashboards that are looking at data across all these different working parts of your organization and bring that into one dashboard for your leadership team to get actionable insights in one consolidated place that is using data that lives in a bunch of other areas. For us, that doesn't pertain to this specific example, so we'll move on. And here we're talking about our values, and you're gonna see our group by. So what I really wanna see is perhaps the status here. So I wanna look at my different status values. So here we are, I can see the number of these that are not sent, sent, overdue, and paid. Now the count doesn't really help me a whole ton here. So you'll notice that that particular part is coming from that values right here. Now this might be helpful for me if I just want to get a gauge for how many overdue invoices do I have or how many invoices are in these various status, but it doesn't really help me to understand the volume of those invoices in terms of the size of the invoice itself. Obviously, it's a lot more important for us to collect on a $50,000 invoice than a $2,000 invoice. So this alone might not be the best metric. Instead, I might want to look at that total again, and I can group this by some different things. In this case, maybe the status field. And this is going to give me a much better indication of where I'm at financially. Look, this is how much of your total invoices have been paid, but you've got almost $50,000 in invoices here that haven't even been sent out. You've really got to get on the accounts receivable team for sending these invoices out, otherwise you're never going to get paid. And also, this is a bit of a red flag. You've got $36,000 in invoices that are in the overdue status. You better get to work, right? So here's where we're able to bring in some actionable insights that help us as leaders of our organization drive better results. Now, in terms of our sent and not yet overdue, we're doing pretty well. And so we know that, hey, once we send an invoice, for the most part, we're sitting pretty. So these are, again, those different ways that we can set up various types of charts, graphs, metrics to allow us to build better businesses. Now, one more thing I want to highlight here is the benchmark line. This is so, so easy to set up. Again, this is very similar to the goal that I showed in the previous widget that we highlighted, but I can set up just like a dashed line if we have a goal. So I might say goal here. I can change the color of how this is going to show up, and maybe I want to set this at 40 grand. And you notice that once I finish that up, I've got this nice little goal showing up here. And the best part about the benchmark is I can have multiple. So I might establish different goals for different teams or different people within my organization. And of course, I can have these different goals. They're going to show up on the graph. I can assign different colors, etc. Once I'm happy, add the widget, and there it is. Now, lastly, when we're building these dashboards, I do want to point out that we can resize all of these things. And we are not just constricted to the widgets themselves. The dashboard functionality in SmartSuite is very versatile, and we can include things like text and other things just to make it easier for us and for our users to navigate. So I might just set up a text block that says, check out these graphs. And of course, I can change the heading style, add this widget, and I can drop this little text block wherever I want within my dashboard. So a lot of flexibility in terms of how we present this data, and of course, how we share this data, because this dashboard lives here inside of our invoices application. So depending on who we've shared access to this application with, they will or will not be able to see this dashboard. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. Dashboards are an incredibly powerful feature inside of SmartSuite, and I encourage you to use it more if you don't already. That's it for this one. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.